Hello and welcome back, Kingdom Citizens. Denzel here. I'm going to be discussing with you the infinite banking concept and cryptocurrencies. I'm going to share with you my 25-year savings strategy on how I use the infinite banking concept and how I look at the crypto space, the whole cryptocurrency, the whole entire industry. And I'm looking to simply use my savings dollars to increase efficiency. This is a long-term strategy, okay? So it requires a lot of discipline, requires consistency, and the end goal is to create income where I pull from the asset, I start to drain it after a period of time via savings dollars, not investment dollars. Every dollar that I'm gonna be discussing here are savings. So this is my protective money, protective measures that is going to eventually create an income stream that is going to protect other assets, other investments, taxes, you name it, okay? So we're just going to be discussing savings dollars using two different vehicles. Infinite banking concept, whole life insurance, cryptocurrency. Going to be sharing with you the cryptocurrencies that I invest in, just so you can see, but we're going to be focusing mainly on one cryptocurrency that I'm simply saving my dollars in due to the very, very high interest rates that it's paying on that specific currency. So with that being said, let's dive right into the lesson. Let's start with the four major numbers like we always do. I'm using my numbers, of course. So my average income per month, roughly 25,000 per month, expenses 10,000, debt zero, cash flow anywhere from 10 to 15,000 or higher per month. This is my current cryptocurrency portfolio. I have Ethereum, Bitcoin, USDC, CRO, Cardano, Polkadot. These are all different cryptocurrencies. The one we're going to be focusing on, and I broke down the percentages in terms of where I have my money allocated in, and I've also listed the rate of return that I'm getting when I stake these particular currencies. So with Ethereum and Bitcoin, I'm getting a 6.5% rate of return. USDC, I'm getting 12%, CRO, 6, Cardano, 3, Polkadot, 12.5%. I am simply accumulating, holding, staking the currency, right, where I lock up the currency, and I'm getting paid a rate of return to hold the cryptocurrency at a staking position where that can be used to advance the cryptocurrency itself, different projects around the world, etc., etc., etc. This is a straight up saving strategy. This isn't a get rich quick. This is get rich for sure. Okay, that's all I'm interested in is getting rich for sure, not getting rich quick. I'm interested in protective measures with my money as I'm operating, actively working in my business, creating income. Over the next 25 years, my goal is to replace my physical ability to work and produce and have all of these savings vehicles and investment vehicles overtake my activity. So no matter how much I work, my investments pay higher. The dividends pay higher than what I'm able to produce. This then puts me in a position at my later years in life, you know, the third and fourth quarter of my life, where I don't have to work. I want to work. I choose to work. I can become more philanthropic. I can be more giving. I can be more of a blessing. I can allocate my time into different areas wherever I so please, according to my king's will, okay, as I live my life here on earth. So with that being said, just want to lay that out, be fully transparent all the way through. Now, infinite banking, for the most part, we have a general idea for depending on the time that you're watching this video, but for most people watching that have gotten to this stage where you've got a policy in place, you're using it, you're making money. I'm speaking to those people. I'm not speaking to people who are just getting started with your personal finances. I'm not speaking to you right now. I'm not speaking to those that are making low income. I'm not speaking to those that are making a low cash flow, bad credit, poor habits. I'm not speaking to you. I'm speaking to my more advanced clients and viewers on YouTube when I eventually post this out, but I'm specifically talking to my experienced, disciplined clients, higher income levels, higher cash flow, good credit. You either have a policy in place or you're in the process of implementing one, or maybe you're on your second, third, fourth, fifth policy, whichever it is. I'm speaking to you right now. So this is why I'm gonna skip past all of the explanation of the tools and just reveal the strategy. We can obviously have a conversation offline, one-on-one, if you're at that point. If you're in the manifesto, obviously we can recap when we have those private networking meetings together and we discuss, we do Q&A, hot seat coaching, whatever it is, we can discuss that. So I'm just gonna lay out the strategy today. So I've got my IBC policy. I'm using Guardian, funding 70 grand a year. I've got two policies, one with MassMutual, one with Guardian. Total amount of savings dollars going into those two policies, 85,000 a year. Total savings dollars, okay? I then take a loan out of $15,000, okay? And I'm gonna be charged, this is 2021, anywhere from 5% to 6% is my loan interest rate. Starting in 2022, the loan interest rates will go down, be a little bit lower. So when I borrow against my policy, cash value loan, boom, 15,000. That whole 15,000 is going into USDC, which is a stable cryptocurrency, pegged to the US dollar, dollar for dollar swap. I'm swapping $15,000 US to 15,000 USDC stable coin. And then on a particular platform called crypto.com, I am able to earn a 12% rate of return. And I'll dive into the qualifications to get there. A recap, IBC policy, taken out a $15,000 loan. I'm gonna pay 5% to 6% loan interest. This 15,000 lands in my checking account, which then I transfer, move it over to the crypto.com platform. I'll attach my phone so that I can show you my screen. You can see the app, what it looks like, what to download, see the different portfolio that I got. You can see the terms. I'll share all that in a little bit. When I put the 15,000 in, I'm gonna be earning a 12%. That's 1,800 on the first year. I'm taking roughly a little under 18% of my savings dollars that's going into IBC. So 85,000 times 18%, I think that's 15,300. So I round down 15 grand, okay? If all I do every single year, 85K goes into the policy, I take 15 out, I put it in crypto, I buy USDC, dollar for dollar switch, I earn 12% over a 25 year period, contributing 15K a year, earning 12% compounded over 25 years, it'll end up just shy of $2 million, okay? And I'll be 50 years old, currently 25. So I'll be 50 years old, roughly almost $2 million in USDC. From there, at age 50, I could stop contributing 15K and I can withdraw. I can start taking distributions anywhere from 150 to 200,000 income per year and never run out of the principal, right? At age 50, if I stop contributing, 12% on 1.9 million is a little under $250,000. So I can withdraw under that amount and still maintain the principal, 1.93 million, can maintain that. So that's one option. Another option is I can just continue to keep contributing to it. When I'm 59, when I'm 69, I mean, this number will 2X, 3, 4, 5, 6X, you know, over my lifespan. At some point, I'm gonna want to withdraw, right? And that can overtake what I bring in terms of income, right? So if I'm averaging 300K a year now, if all I did was average 300K a year over the next 25 years, right, I could live off of just this crypto, USDC. If all goes well, right, maintain the same interest rate, if all goes well, I can withdraw 150 to 200K a year, okay? So that is my intention long-term. If things change, I'll update you. But as of right now, this is my savings strategy that is gonna accumulate wealth long-term, which then can be income later on. And I withdraw a certain amount of money per year and never run out of the principal. That's the goal. A rule, I invest no more than 5% of my income per year in cryptocurrency. So I'm averaging, over the last 3 years that I've been in business, I'm averaging about 300 to 350K a year. So I took the lower number, 300K, right? And that's how I'm basing off my numbers. 5% of 300K, 15,000 bucks. So $15,000 of my total income gets invested, right? 5%, I'm sorry. 300K times 5% is 15 grand. So $15,000 is being invested into Ethereum, Bitcoin, Cardano, CRO, Polkadot, and other cryptocurrencies along the way. But I'll probably just stay within the top 10 cryptocurrencies and see how it all lays out. And those are earning rates of returns as well. Those will also provide stream of income 25 years from now, if all goes well. That's the risk part, 5% of my income. So my savings dollars, 85,000 is what I save per year off of my average income, right? That 85K, take 18% of that, you're gonna get roughly 15K, boom. And that's what I used to buy the USDC coin, all right? The strategy again, we're saving to accumulate for long-term growth plus income at that later age. After 50, I can go to 59, whenever I want. I mean, I could even stop as early as, you know, 18 years into it. I could do, I can withdraw 70 grand a year and never run out of the principal, right? So 25 years I felt was ideal. I'm 25 years old right now, I'll be 50. Still got plenty of years to live if all goes well. Health is good, all that. Now let's talk about the qualifications to get these interest rates in the crypto space. So again, I'm specifically focusing on one platform. There's a lot of different, you know, rewards and features and benefits and whatnot. I like crypto.com. That's my favorite out of all of them. This card that you see right here is what gets me access to these higher rates. As of 2021, it costs $4,000 worth of CRO. As of 2021, as I'm recording this video, one CRO token, which is the native cryptocurrency on crypto.com, is floating at around 17, 18 cents per coin. So in order to obtain this card, this is a debit card. Here are some of the card features. I get 3% cashback rewards on everything I buy using this card. I have a VIP lounge to different airports. I just show the card and I can get into the different private VIP lounges. I get 100% cashback reimbursement on my Netflix and Spotify subscription. So that's $143 every year and $107 every year. Cash back. So I just put the money on the card, I load it, and I spend it, and I get it back in the form of CRO. The strategy there is I'm accumulating these CROs to get to the next card, which cost $40,000. And then the next card after that is $400,000. And there's much bigger rewards, higher staking rates, very, very exclusive type of access. This current card costs $4,000. Over 25 years, I'll accumulate so much CRO through spending and cashback rewards and just accumulating and purchasing as I invest and as I stake and keep earning and earning and earning. Just by that, I'll eventually get to that very, very high level access. Another fast track way to get there, in my opinion, is I'm also advertising in their favor. I'm promoting their product. I'm saying, hey, I'm a customer and I love the product. The card is great. Very slick design, nice weight to it. The cashback rewards, the card features are awesome. So I'm talking good things about them. Have not had an issue. I'm able to load money on the card. I can take cash out at the ATM. I've yet to have an issue yet. So therefore, when I promote them, they see me on social media, they may want to do business with me at some point in time. if I keep talking about them. They also have a referral program where when I refer people to get the card, right, or just to create an account on crypto.com, I get 25 bucks, they get 25 bucks. So you can imagine over the years, the amount of people that I'm going to refer to that product over the next 25 years, I might refer 25,000 people. 25,000 people times $25, what is that? 25,000 times $25, $625,000, right? Over say 25 year period, and I can use that money to buy more of their CRO or USDC, whatever it is, and keep accumulating, right? Again, could be a stream of income, sponsorship opportunities. Who knows? They may want to pay me to promote their brand. So right now I'm doing it for free. Over time, they say, oh, wow, this person's been promoting us quite a bit. Let's feed into that. He's bringing us so much business. Let's feed into that. From a business to business standpoint, that's going to be a great relationship. So that's another strategy in all of that as well. Now, to create an account, some of the steps, I recommend you create a separate email, right? Totally different email, totally different password. Download the app, attach that email, totally different password. Set up your PIN code, Face ID. It's still considered the Wild Wild West in the crypto space where there's a lot of scams, there's a lot of fraud, hacking. So you want to do everything in your power to reduce that. And so the more you separate, you don't want to connect everything to all your other accounts. So use different passwords, different passcodes, different email. And I think that would be more beneficial. I also would use a totally separate bank account. Now, I have run into some issues personally in regards to sending money to different crypto platforms. The major banks and even smaller banks are not so crypto friendly. What I mean by that is it's kind of tough to send direct deposits via ACH to these different crypto platforms. That's been my experience. One bank that has been very, very easy is Chase Bank, surprisingly. So I personally use Chase Bank, set up a totally different personal checking account, and I move money from my main business and personal accounts, and I send money to Chase Bank, and then I transfer money from Chase Bank to crypto.com platform. Couple little extra steps there. I found Chase Bank to be very, very helpful since I've been, you know, no issues. I'll just say that. No issues so far. Chase Bank's been very transparent, very easy. I see the money within 2 days. The money's right there in the account, and I move it either to the card or I buy the different cryptocurrencies. Pretty good stuff. Create that new email, download the app, set up the new bank account, buy a hard wallet. I prefer the Ledger Nano X, and I'm gonna go ahead and pull it out so you can see it. This is what it looks like. This is the Ledger Nano X. It's a hard wallet. Eventually, I will accumulate so much cryptocurrency that I'm gonna start withdrawing off the platform into a private, it's like a private bank account. Only I have access to this hard wallet. This is gonna create a hedge just in case the platform gets hacked, just in case there's any issues, just in case I can't get access to my cryptocurrency. Eventually, I'm gonna start moving some of those coins off the app into the hard wallet and keep some on the app so I can keep earning those high staking rates. So that's my strategy with that. Buy the hard wallet. When you download the app, you can use the referral code right here, this 6R5KXCUNFK, right? I can even email it to you. If you're having any issues, you can, you know, send me an email and I can help you with that along the way. But when you create that account, use the referral code. And I think you have to do something. You have to buy, I guess, a certain amount. I'm not sure of the rules, but essentially, if you do everything right, you get 25 bucks, I get 25 bucks, a free $25 to start, and that's awesome. And then you can do the same. You can refer your family and friends to do the same thing, and you're gonna get the referral code. It's not much really that goes into it. So here we are. This is my little tab where I have all my crypto apps. So I've got that Chase Bank right there. I use Coinbase, and I've got the crypto.com, right? So we're gonna open that crypto.com. At the top, it'll show your balance. I'm hiding it at the moment. That's not really an important number for you guys. So let's go over to account, and this is where this is super easy to use, in my opinion. Very, very user friendly. This is the crypto wallet. This is showing what I have in my wallet. So I got the crypto, Ethereum, this thing called Quant, very, very little in that. Bitcoin, Theta Fuel, Cardano, Polkadot, USDC coin. I'm in my first year of investing, right, in cryptocurrency. Started in 2020-ish, kind of went a little more harder in 2021. Now I have consistent numbers. Every year, 15,000 is gonna go into USDC. So you can see how I've got the, you know, 16,000, certainly, 16,290 of USDC, earning 12% every three months, but over the 1 year, it'll equal 12%. So it gets divided up into like 3 months. So the fiat wallet, right, where I'm able to add money to the fiat wallet. This is when I'm sending money from Chase to the crypto platform. So it'll, my money will show up there in the fiat wallet, and then I buy cryptocurrencies, transfer, sell, whatever it is. Crypto Visa card. This is where I can see my transactions, what I spend money on, right? You see all these different stuff. I'm getting cashback rewards. We can see over here the transaction history. I can go over here to the card itself, right? And go to full card details. This is the Jade Green card that currently costs $4,000 of CRO. 3% cash back, 100% back on Spotify and Netflix, 10% stake reward. So I'm getting 10%, right, on certain things that I, certain cryptocurrencies. Got the airport lounge, higher limits to earn in CRO, no annual fee, no monthly fees, no delivery fees. Purchase and hold $4,000 worth of CRO, 180 days to receive the Jade Green card, right? Not bad at all. So let me show you what it looks like when you go on the CRO itself. This is the native token. So right now, $4,700 of CRO is $25,285 CRO. If I went over here to upgrade, these are the different levels. The first level, $400. Second level, $4,000. I'm at the second level. Here's the third level, $40,000 worth of CRO. You get 12%, right? So it goes up by 2%. Airport lounge, plus one guest, Amazon Prime, 100% back on your Amazon Prime membership. That's awesome. Bunch of other stuff included in there. Then the final card, $400,000 worth of CRO, right? So pretty interesting stuff here. Very, very exclusive, right? That's pretty expensive to me right now. Very exclusive program. Nonetheless, this is the literally exchange right here. You can trade, boom, buy, sell. Super easy to use in my opinion. I like it a lot. And I keep it in one area. Then I got the Ledger Live. That's the hard wallet. This DeFi wallet right here is in combination with the crypto.com. And that's another place where you can store cryptocurrencies. Coinbase, that's another platform. Chime Bank was a bank that I tried to move money with. Didn't really love it. Bank of America was an issue. PNC Bank was an issue. Brightstar Credit Union was an issue. A lot of different banks I had issues with, but Chase Bank, very, very useful in my opinion. So coming back to the board, just to recap, I use my infinite banking policy to save money. That's where I'm parking my savings. It's tax-free growth. It has liquidity. I then borrow against the cash value, collateral loan, right? The insurance company gives me their money. My cash value continues to grow uninterrupted interest. It's gonna earn that dividend rate as if I never touched the money. Meanwhile, the insurance company is charging 5 to 6% on interest, right? What I do in addition, right? So this is the savings part. I'm also borrowing out other money, right? Out of my policy, borrowing against the policy, and I'm investing in other things. I personally, from my cash flow, I pay the loan interest every year on the policy. That's what I do personally. It works best for me in my opinion. I never harm the interest. So I'm not taking the 12% gain and netting 6 or 7 to pay back the loan interest on the policy. I don't do that. I leave the saving strategies and the investment strategies alone. I let those grow over the next 25 years. I let them grow. I don't touch it. I continue to produce income. I continue to my principles of saving, investing, and tithing and giving, right? That additional cash flow that sits in my bank does nothing. I pay the interest back to myself. That interest comes back to the insurance company. Insurance company pays a dividend. That cash value continues to grow. So I'm earning interest in two locations. That same 15 grand is earning interest in here and earning interest in the crypto. So it's like a protective measure on top of the protection that life insurance, cash value life insurance has to offer already. I'm just enhancing it, right? Any questions at all, send me an email. If you're already in the course, you're already in the manifesto, we'll have additional conversations where I break this down even further, use your numbers to see where you're at, see what you want to do. I found this to be the most safest way, in my opinion, based on the knowledge that I have so far, the safest way for me to enter this crypto space that's here to stay, not going anywhere, all right, over $2 trillion market cap, I think, amongst all the different cryptocurrencies. A lot of money has been poured into this. Retail investors, whales, banks, institutions, insurance companies, Mass Mutual bought $100 million of Bitcoin, I think. I heard that from Garrett Gunderson. So this is secondhand information. I think this is here to stay. I'm looking at places where I can earn these safe rates of returns and I don't have to really do anything, right? I'm not working for this money, not doing anything. My activity is working with you guys, creating content, being a coach, being a consultant, right? Being a kingdom citizen, working in my craft, being a public speaker, collaborating with other influencers, other businesses, other churches, getting paid at a very high rate. I then make the money. Now I gotta keep it, manage it, steward it while I'm here on planet Earth. That being said, have a wonderful day. God bless, and we'll be talking soon.